What are you doing? Mark Jones.
You're on now.
Hey, okay, the Facebook Mentions live stream on Facebook is going to be a little different tonight. We're going to, I don't know, we haven't actually asked Dalton Rapitone if he'll take the live stream and answer all your questions, but I think he's a really good guy, so yeah. We'll give it a shot. I'll just say, you know, make an approach like I usually would. Okay, if you're a good guy, you'll do this. If you're not, you won't. No, he's a great guy. We're glad to have him in the station. Back for the hometown visit. He's from Sunnyvale, and so he's in the top four of American Idol. It's pretty sweet. Let's go check it out.
Hi, I'm Robert.
Hey, Robert.
Producer Robert McLeod. Steve, great. Nice to meet you.
Hi, I'm Claire. Nice to meet you.
Claire, nice to meet you.
I'm just going to go see this Facebook thing working. In
a so, you guys have been on the whole trip?
Yeah.
Essentially?
Yeah.
They're, fun. I was going to say fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have fun. You went to a little nutty. Yeah. All right, we're rolling, Owen.
We're rolling, guys. Roll out.
Yep.
Yeah, how you doing?
Good.
Here. I'm not going to get the interview. It's going to be Brandon Todd. Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm great.
Good. I heard somebody say, you know, this is going to be live. It's a good thing you don't have to sing, right? I mean, you've been singing live for long enough. Okay, so something we do, you do like a Facebook Live broadcast? Do you do that?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if we do this every night on the newscast. I don't know if at some point he's going to want to hand that to you, and maybe during the downtime you can just, you know, flip the camera on and talk to people.
Yeah.
And it's usually, we get up to, I don't know, how many views we got. The other night we had 130,000.
Wow.
So, I mean, with you, we've been promoting it. And that's cool.
Very cool, yeah.
Is that cool? It'd be more casual than, that's something I'm sure you do all the time.
Yeah.
Anyway, okay, so it's going to be, has Brandon been down? Have you met Brandon?
Yeah.
Okay, good. All right. You want to hang on to that?
Yeah, I'll hang on to it and I'll kind of lurk back here and we'll see what's going on.
Have you shown everybody?
Hello, it is me, Dalton.
Yay, Dalton, welcome
home.
How are
you, people? Thank you. Oh, man. That's cool. I like the little, the holdy thing that you guys have.
It's a tripod, we can set it down, it's pretty cool. But
it's got magnets on the bottom, so.
So you can read the comments and see. I'm not sure if anybody has seen you yet. Yeah, good luck, Dalton.
Thank you very much.
Since your audition.
That's awesome.
Can't see you. They were waiting. Let's show him.
And they're more than just Dallas Fort Worth. So we got people from like Memphis and Jersey and all over the country. So,
hi Kathy. Nice to meet you, Kathy.
That's cool. Thanks for playing along.
Thank you.
Welcome here.
So yeah, we're just gonna give you control of this thing. You can answer questions. You don't have to.
Okay.
Or I'll just kind of follow you around. Whatever's cool.
Wherever you want to go, he's gonna follow you around. If you want to take him to the weather center, sure.
Okay.
If you want to go to the studio, feel free.
Hey,
if
get lost. That's
control room. Feel free. You want to go to the bath? Well, we don't want to do that. Get too far. You can take it upstairs. You can take it outside. Whatever. As long as you're here in this seat for the interview, we're good to go.
Okay.
Brandon's gonna be talking to you. All right, so that's the route. It's at 9:15 or so. There will be a quick tease.
Told you, Lou makes it happen.
Yeah.
So mute your cell phone.
I can get one upstairs. Let me run upstairs. Raul, do you have a piece of tape handy? How's he doing?
He just looks...
He looks overwhelmed, right?
Yeah, he looks overwhelmed. That's why I'm kind of giving him a little bit of breathing space, because...
Mic check, so...
It was weird having a picture of him when he's just sitting there like, I just want a moment's peace before the crazy starts, so... That's why I'm back in here.
Brandon, keep talking for me, please. Brandon, keep talking. Stolen from a college student.
Yep.
Only on Fox 4, our news crew recovering expensive bikes stolen from a college.
We're going to need that with Dalton at the top of the show.
Yeah. Responded and started questioning.
Okay.
Hi, Lou.
Hey, can you share that shit?
Are you good, Lou? I'm on.
You did? Okay. Just now? Okay.
30 seconds.
You got it
okay? Yeah. They were trying to do a mic check.
See if he can hold it.
No, I just...
Huh?
He looks really overwhelmed.
Yeah.
So I didn't want to...
Completely, like, bombard him.
Yeah, because he's just... You see him kind of rubbing his face. He's just
Brandon,
little... He just looks really overwhelmed.
Is he doing this? Hold on, that's part of the show.
Hold on. Brandon, we're going to put this over the Apple logo.
Okay.
All
right, let's get that zoomed in on him.
Amen.
Is that live right now?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, more or less. Nice. Essentially, that's really well.
We had to start over. We actually maxed it out. It's 90 minutes. So we maxed out the time and had to start a second broadcast. And grand total was probably about
2 hours. They're leaving comments. We don't have any power over taking cover, and this is the only thing.
It's crazy. When you get a comment that says, I'm in my closet.
Yeah.
It's like okay, responsibility. But yeah, they're a great bunch. I mean, we've got a lot of people who are regulars and a lot of people who are so, you know, they're hearing me, so I'm trying to watch them. You know, they've got a pretty loyal following, and it's nationwide. So people like, hey, you're watching me in New Jersey. Hey, I used to live in Dallas. I live in Oregon now, so it's really nice.
How far away are we?
We're live on
And we're in the show right now.
So, is that just super hot? Connected high that speed or something?
They just added. They just upgraded our Wi-Fi system to a Aruba network. It used to be on a bunch of different routers. It's all centrally located.
Crazy. Now you gotta get this.
You want to see what everybody's saying?
No, I saw it.
Oh, you did? Okay.
That's live, if you want to just, say very few. Thank you. Nothing like a live Facebook. Looks drunk. No, not quite.
right now, there are about 600. We can get about 12 to 400 to 2,000. Yeah, he's actually on the set right now. Steve's already used to act on this one. With a brief interruption for...
Hello, everyone. I'm here at Fox in Dallas. We've got all of this stuff with all these pictures of me. Where did those come from? Am I right? The photo store? Probably. Oh, man. Yeah, if anybody wants to ask any questions, I'll answer them if I can. Don't be nervous. I'm not nervous. I'm just, it's, these schedules are pretty crazy. I'm quite tired. Oh, thank you, Belinda.
Shot in the dark, did you guys know it was an officer who had been like a guest of JD, someone that they were so good?
That's funny, Joyce. I do need Starbucks, that is true. That is very true. My eyeliner is, it came off in the plane right over here. It doesn't fare too well on long days like this. But, it still exists. Thank you, Jeremy. Fun fact about God Only Knows, my in-ears, which help me hear my voice, which help me hear my voice, while I'm on stage, they fell out in the middle of the song. So literally, from the time that I sat down on, I could not hear myself at all. So I'm glad to hear that it didn't turn out horribly. As I feared. Last night I got none. The night before that it was show day, right? So I got three. Yeah, we had the call time was like 7:30. Yeah, it's fun. It's a good time. We had fun here. I think I'm done boring these poor people.
I doubt that. Seriously.
You should interview DK, our crew.
Yeah,
interview DK.
I don't know. I'm not as glamorous or as quick thinking or as talented as Dalton.
I am none of those things. I am literally zero of those things.
DK is owner of the Party Bus.
Just
Show me the party bus.
Okay,
moves.
See, there you go.
That, see the party bus moves.
That is the party bus. The party bus moves?
Yeah, yeah.
They have a wide angle. See, I could just need a
keep
wide
step angle. Back.
Need a wide angle.
Trust me.
When you're ready for the, ready for the party bus, let me know. Rob is definitely the driver. Rob, bus driver?
He's consulting.
Otto from The Simpsons has nothing on Rob.
You might want to warn me.
Okay. Okay.
No. Where
it should be. He says he doesn't like that. He says he needs a hair. He needs a hair dye. He's got to get the hair fixed.
I wouldn't crowdsource that.
I'm just saying.
That's the best comment so far. I hope you get 10 hours of sleep later.
Oh my God, thank you.
Oh, so Joyce sweet. Beck Bishop, Dalton says thank you.
That was so sweet.
We're about to come up to you in how many minutes?
It's a wonderful
what do you have left in the package?
This is the first bite cheese.
I know. Minute 30.
Minute 30?
Mm-hmm.
Was he taking over the iPad or iPhone?
He was on the iPhone just a little while ago.
Now you can just show him in about a minute 30. Thank you.
Which one is it?
Should there just be a rule, whoever has the camera he's supposed to look at just waves?
Right.
And I'll make it easier, I'll just stand behind her.
music behind us.
Yeah.
So I'll make sure we got it. You're getting behind us. You're staying on the action.
I'm gonna do both.
Standby.
Here comes the tease, everybody. Boom! And we are clear from the tees.
Longest tees ever.
Yeah. is there a place that I can make urine?
Right here.
Right there?
Yep. Right past those double doors.
Yet another microphone.
Okay, no problem.
You okay with that?
Yeah.
Excellent. Is it okay if I put it in your lapel pocket? Yeah. You okay?
All right. What do they say? This is one of those good problems?
Yeah, right, yes.
Got it? You good?
Yes.
What do you need?
A small piece of tape?
Probably.
Time.
Minute and a half.
Hey, Brandon. Thank you so much.
Here's
the,
so I got
that
also.
No problem.
Thank you for
taking
the time.
We'll give it back to
him.
Mic check,
Brandon.
When do they want me to do that?
Whenever they want to. Brandon, mic check. Dalton Rapp joining us.
Oh, that's just there from before,
Brandon. Brandon, sit here. Oh.
Brandon.
We're still waiting on the video from the radio session. It's taking a little while.
I'm not sure.
Okay. Just don't reference it specifically.
1 minute.
Radio interview after you talk about it.
Yes, okay.
It just may not be. Oh, we have video of that. Just don't say that.
Okay.
It may not be there.
Okay.
So we can talk about it.
If it is,
it'll
be very
happy.
Okay.
So, all
right.
How's that?
There's the new nipple measure.
That's all we have right there.
You can do it on the end. Toward the end before you
read that. Back on?
30 seconds.
Pardon me. That would have been a good lot.
30 seconds.
You
good?
Turn around.
30 seconds.
For a second?
30 seconds.
Come back. What is this cracking me?
I know. Here, you want to remind people that it's you now?
Somebody in the studio.
Okay. We're watching. Everybody here?
3, 2, 1.
Here we go.
Tony is pretty good, man. Thanks a lot. Hey, so should I call you Salty Belty? Or is that the sign that I saw? What is that?
That's kind of my nickname around like the idle camp is Salty Dalty because I'm pretty crabby in the morning.
Okay.
They call me, they're like, oh my god, Dalty, he's so salty. Salty Dalty came from that. Also, I have like a hat and glasses that make me look like a grandma. So they call me Grandma Salty.
Well, pirates catch or anything,
but
that's
all. No, but they call
me
Grandma Salty. Okay,
Grandma Salty. Yeah. All right, big night for you last night. Huge night for you. We're going to play that moment when your name is called.
Producer, I am not down there. I'm down here.
All right, so we watched that play out. I mean, 10 seconds before your name is called.
I'm thinking, like, bye, everybody. And it was really strange.
You sort of braced for the worst, man.
Yeah, because Sonic is so amazing. Like, her voice is incredible, but I don't know if you were able to see, but right before they called my name, she read the card. And she looked at me and said, it's you. And like, I was almost like, I was sad about it because like Sonic was a good friend of mine and none of these eliminations are going to be easy from now on, even if I make it through. Just because like, we're all friends and it does kind of suck to see your buddy leave.
Yeah, exactly. All right, so talk about tomorrow. You've got a huge day tomorrow.
Yeah.
Your grandmother's slime, you know, this is that. You know, it's a school of rock, and you go there talk about it.
Yeah. No, I'm going to this Villagers Beauty Salon in the morning tomorrow. And then I'm going to pop over to School of Rock at Rockwall, where I taught and still my teach. And then we've got the parade in
No, I cannot.
I need you to back up prompter.
I didn't do it. What's going on?
I know somebody's moving it back and forth, and I thought that you and Brandon were the only people who would do that.
Oh, hi.
That video made it online.
Tim, I've had the same hairstylist for 18 years. Kim Dolan, she's incredible.
Oh, wow.
She's always trying to get me to spruce up my hair with that TV guy hair. All right, my question.
Okay, here's a side light. I don't know what's going on. They said I gotta roll back the prompter to 220. I didn't do anything with the prompter. I'm not in the studio. I don't know what they want. Such is life. Somebody messed with it. What do they want? What is the deal? What are they talking about? We're way past this stuff. Way past it. What do they want? Call the control room and find out what they want. All right, here. I got it, I guess. Okay. This must be it.
Okay, he's Steve on Conqueror Instinct. So that's good.
Well, he doesn't have a tele... Who's going to control it for him? This is insane. Who's going to roll it for him?
Well, the question is, who's going to roll it for him? Who's going to roll it the prompter for him? She didn't know.
Beautiful.
Okay.
This is just a preemptive thing they're doing? He has scripts.
I know.
Let me get you back to Dalton. Sorry.
If something goes wrong, if something's going to go wrong every single time.
He does need the pedal or something.
Kind of
I don't know what's going on.
I like about it too. I don't want to be perfect. And I don't want every show to go off without a hitch. That's the fun of it. Yeah. That's why I'm a musician.
All right, we did the math here. And when I interviewed Kelly Clarkson, when she won, you were 4 years old.
What?
Man,
yeah.
That makes me feel old. All right. So, you know, obviously, you know she's from Burleson.
Yeah. I didn't know that.
Winner of first season from North Texas?
Yeah, I keep
winner
saying,
of the final season from North
Texas?
I'm hoping
so. That would be pretty dope.
I mean, to bookend it like that?
Yeah, we got to pull it together, though.
Wow.
We got to go, man.
That would be pretty cool.
Yeah.
All right. All right, now we did some digging on you. We did discover that you were in a boy band.
Oh, stop.
All right, no, we cannot leave without playing even just a little segment.
Oh, God, no! Why this video? Why this one?
This is,
No, no, no! Any video but this one! This is the worst!
This is pure boy band,
oh
right?
Oh my God, what did I do with her hair? It was so chunky! What happened? Oh, sucks. This is so mean.
This is good!
No, stop it! God, get it off! Get it off!
Alright, so it's called Touchdown, Dan.
Stop!
So this is like really good. This is good boy band stuff. It's a catchy tune.
I want to die.
I mean, it's a catchy tune.
Oh, it's the worst.
So I Am Five, real quick. The boy band name. What, did you come up with that? Or
no,
what?
No.
Okay.
It was so manufactured. It was ridiculous. There was like a whole audition process, and none of us knew anybody in the band until we started it. Oh God!
Thank God,
the top of the screen.
Oh, that's great.
No, we were. This is just a suggestion to anybody
looking to form a
boy band. Don't do that. Literally, do everything opposite of what you just saw on screen. Oh, that was terrible.
Dalton, good luck, man.
Thank you.
Good luck. Thanks for joining. I appreciate it. Now, it's going to be a busy day, as we mentioned, for Dalton tomorrow. At 8:30 in the morning, he'll be at, and we could have somebody advance that or hand you the script. Anyway, you've got a busy day. You're going to be in Sunnyvale.
Yes.
You'll be in the beauty salon in North Dallas.
Yes.
10 o'clock, School of Rock.
Yes.
4 o'clock for Ravens.
Sure.
And 5 o'clock for Ravens.
A new term for many of you, first time hearing the term gender fluid, caused some confusion and some judgment. That story and many more packed into tonight's viewer's voice. Why is this? I hear. Love you people. Hope everybody. We try to overextend. Isn't that when usually when something isn't? Every night we do this, it's smooth sailing, and then we try to do
it's called the law of diminishing returns.
Yeah, not good.
We would like to thank Steve Eager for so eagerly running the prompter for Brandon. Just kidding.
Did anybody?
I'm just playing with you.
Into Dalton land.
Yeah,
we're sure. We're headed back into Dalton land. So anyway, it's just another Friday night here at Fox 4. And so now we're headed back into Dalton land.
Nothing else for the camera or the show.
We got the social media.
You can actually see where I give it to.
No, I don't believe so.
Right.
You can actually be anywhere you want. You want to go to the newsroom, you can.
Oh, dope.
Let's take a walk,
Claire.
Let's walk.
I don't know.
So are we in the Facebook section of this? I think we're doing the social media right now. We're on live.
Yeah, I'm kind of
talking about for the show.
They got an awesome. Anything more on air?
You want to come down to the newsroom? You want to see the newsroom?
Yeah.
Okay. Off we go.
If y'all want to say hi, go up say hi to him. Go, 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 go. Go, 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 go. It's fine. It's fine. I told you, go say hi. Seriously. I can't do it.
Get on the
corner. Go. Hey, Dalton, can I get a group photo with you?
Absolutely.
You got a fan club here.
Absolutely, yeah.
My daughters and their friends.
Very cool.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Appreciate it. Good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
I brought a motor on. What is that's where
we're going to be. Can you see the water? There, don't we couldn't possibly talk to him. He's standing right there, but we couldn't possibly talk to
him. Is J-Lo cool? Yeah, she's very, very cool. The thing is, every interaction that I've had with J-Lo, because we don't hang out with the judges offscreen, which kind of sucks, because they did back in the day. But it came back to like be a fairness issue, I guess, so the judges like someone personally, they want to have to live in the
moment. Because there's always like one day, one more like
some. Yeah.
Oh, he's just over there talking to me. Yeah. Yeah, good luck with that. If someone were to be.
Well, I think we should.
Okay. If you want to just go ahead and take it. So if you want to go ahead and tell me, we'll go ahead and do promos.
So I ended
up with a few Kelly, go say hi. Seriously. He's just talking to Zan.
All right, Dalton, we're ready for you. I think we just got a couple more things and then we're good. We're just going to get something for American Idol right now.
Cool. I like that show.
And we're going to be going this way, guys. So if we could clear out, we're basically just going to get a little shot of you as you're walking, talking.
Okay.
Talking, this is, we're going to cheat this for before that.
Okay, come on this
way. We're going to do Facebook Live at 39 straight up. So if we want to shout out.
Solid.
We'll have an extreme close-up of Dalton, I promise you, okay?
Well, not that extreme.
Extreme close-up.
Right. Yeah. Should come on.
Walk into a wall.
This is practice for tomorrow. We'll be good on the
Yes, Mandy, we officially are.
Should be super fun.
Hey, you teased that.
Did you watch it?
Yeah, you have to tease that.
Again?
Did you watch it?
Yeah.
I would have loved it. Chris, not there.
Do one more.
Go. Yeah.
Why don't you be walking out of here?
All right, girls, you gonna stay there? Can you stay there? We're gonna shot.
Did you watch that bump?
Yeah. Thanks for making me look cool, guys.
Last one. Last one. We hit a bump. I just keep them clear of that. One more time.
Just keep clear of all bumps. You got that straight back. And let's have you guys over here. And girls, will you be in that same area? This is welcome to reality TV here. All right, here we go. Yeah, nothing is real. And 3, 2, 1, go.
Hey, how's it going, guys? It's Dalton. We are at Fox Sports in Dallas today, and we're going to be talking about the parade and all of the stuff that's going to happen. It's going to be fun. It's going to be super cool. Television, baby. Woo!
Twice.
Oh, absolutely.
Great. Great.
Thanks,
thank
guys.
You.
Sign a wall. We're going to sign a wall here.
Are we doing?
Sorry.
Am I? Oh,
no, it's just you get used to it. And tomorrow there'll be a lot more people. But it's just.
Beautiful night here in North Texas, but changes are on the way for the Easter holiday weekend, including a chance of rain and cooler temperatures blowing in. I've got all the details.
Bordering on Meta.
But it was a business.
So Jonesy,
right.
Yes, sir. They're gonna put your cam up. So if you want to get them, you want to get them signed.
Hey.
No microphone.
Come back this way. 6, 7, 5, 8, 9.
What happened on my hometown?
Hello, what happened on your hometown?
Hey, Jonesy.
Yes, sir.
Just, you might have tape out just doing that.
I'm with you.
I'm going to show it.
Yep, I'm with you.
All right.
About 2 minutes out.
No problem.
All right, sure about it.
Excellent. I love LA, but it's great to be home.
You had a good day lately?
Can I say?
Whatever you want to say. Absolutely. Absolutely.
That's just what is rehearsed now. I'm Dalton from American Idol.
I understand.
Blank, blank. All right.
And action.
Hey, what's up? I'm Dalton from American Idol. Have you had a good day lately? Good day, Fox
Sports.
All right.
And ready.
I'm Dalton. I'm from Sunnyvale, and I go where the locals go. Good day on Fox Sports.
Beautiful.
I don't know if my hand movements match.
I think they
actually
match. For the heart, you have Texas.
All right,
that's the last one.
Here we go. And Dalton, whatever you are.
Thanks for all the support, everyone. You really do have hearts as big as Texas.
Beautiful. Okay, good. Now we have gifts.
Ready?
Gifts.
We have gifts. Because we know that you're sleep deprived, and you're going to continue to be sleep deprived, please.
What?
The American Idol coffee maker.
No way! That's yours.
No, we've been saving that.
What?
For years.
I know, I saw it at the office. I mean, I saw it, and that's amazing. Thank you.
That's yours.
Oh, my God. What?
Brew it with pride.
That is insane. That's amazing. Wow.
And since you haven't eaten yet, we got you.
No way.
Taco Bueno?
What?
And we got you CC's Pizza.
Yes! Oh, my God. Oh, you've got to be kidding me right now. I was looking at this, I'm like, boy, I hope that's mine. Oh my God, thank you. Wow, what do I look at? Who do I think? Thank you guys so much. Whoa.
Oh, and the good day mug for your coffee.
Yeah.
And one for mom.
So really appreciate that. Thank you guys, really.
Thank you for coming.
You have to eat all of that, by the way.
That's right.
I might. Really might. Oh, that is awesome.
That's for real.
Want to bring it over here?
Let's start from over by the coffee machine, and we'll do that take two on that. Yeah? You guys positioned good?
Yeah, I'm a sneaky guy. You gotta watch out for me.
We'll have you guys back over here. And then, John, you can just say, well, we also got a couple more things for you.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then just come in front so your backs aren't to us,
okay?
On the other side of the table.
Here first.
Yeah, same thing as like you're gonna start over there. Yeah.
Where's the camera so I know which
one here and one here?
Taco Bueno is classic.
Just let us know that.
Yeah, right. Your favorite one was good.
So you're wrapping up, you're finishing up.
Oh, this is awesome. Oh my God.
Oh, okay. So we'll start you there. Yeah. And then, John, you interrupt and tell me what else you got.
All right. So, anyway, this is for you. This is
the
key thing going on your final week. This is the fuel you need to make it to the final.
Awesome. Thank you guys so much. That's so dope. Oh my God.
We've been saving it for you.
Thank you. I've seen it around. That's so cool.
And we also know that you haven't had time to eat. So we want to make sure that while you're here, you've got some home cooking. We got you.
Yes. Taco Bell.
And your favorite pizza.
Oh my gosh. That's amazing.
But then they're like, who's talking about this? Now it's in your life.
Thunderstorms late Saturday night, early Sunday morning, with some small hail on it. Out at Lawrence and Granbury today, a beautiful sunny day, starting out at 32, but warmed all the way up to 73 this afternoon. High fishing at BFW was 69, morning low 41, 71 and 49, the average for this time of the year. Pollen count way up there today at over 1,000, the mold count at 2635, and that UV at 7. Currently, we got low 60s.
Thanks, Mark. Welcome back.
The dew point at 40, the pressure 29.82. Future cast, no repeat of the frost tonight. Low temperatures will range from the mid-40s up around Paris.
Let me check out what is happening in the newscast, and then I'll roam around for a minute.
Just a few clouds coming our way presently. Our next weather system already making its way down towards the Great Salt Lake. It will track to our north. Late Saturday night, early Sunday morning, that means the better rain chances will be, especially as you head up into Oklahoma for the coming weekend. 52 early tomorrow morning, 71 at noon time, 76 at 5 o'clock in the afternoon. So we play out future cast, breezy and mild conditions Saturday afternoon. Here we go Saturday night. This is about 2 o'clock in the morning, and you can see some isolated thunderstorms moving along the Red River Valley. They will continue to move eastward, and then a few showers and maybe a rumble or two of thunder will make its way down into the Dallas-Fort Worth area right around sunrise on Sunday morning. It gets out of here very quickly, and we're left with partly sunny conditions, cooler temperatures for Sunday afternoon. Here's your forewarn AccuWeather 7-day forecast. 77 on Saturday, 64 on Sunday. I'll put that rain chance at 30%. Again, late Saturday night, Sunday morning. Monday, we're up to 70. Tuesday, 77. And some stronger storms possible by the middle of the week.
Christians around the world are remembering the crucifixion of Jesus Christ.
Bishop Kevin Farrell of the Dallas Catholic Diocese led Good Friday Mass at the Cathedral of Guadalupe in downtown Dallas. Chandler Parsons is out for the season after having knee surgery. Can the Mavericks make the playoffs without him, though? I know the Cowboys looking at everyone but quarterbacks for their first-round draft pick. Edward Egross offers his reality check ahead on Fox 4 News at 9.
Go ahead, Brandon. I do it every night. I get enough of
okay,
that.
Okay, I'm not going
to How are we doing?
Yeah. Heather, what are you doing?
How are you? Are you?
Oh, Heather's driving on her phone. I assume you're driving. Hustle up, get home.
Hey!
Hope you had a good vacation.
Money black. Two and a half. Steve, I haven't seen these.
Reality check is taped before a live studio audience.
Edward Egross is in. How you doing, man?
Good, man. How you doing?
I'm doing well.
You know, Edward, we go to this big production with the American Idol guy, and it's the lowest number of viewers in months. What does that mean? I don't know. I know American Idol is getting canceled.
Yeah, there's that.
I don't know. I guess there's a reason.
By the way, I have a shirt just like that.
Really? It's really comfortable.
Oh, no, it's great. It's a great shirt.
Heather is by watching on the phone. If you want to say anything to Heather, you're a good friend.
Not really. Out of sight, out of mind. You know what I mean?
Who?
Who?
I seriously don't know what's happening, but you regular viewers, this is like the biggest production we've ever done for this, and isn't it like the lowest number of viewers? I don't know. I have. You tell me what's wrong. I don't know. It's Friday. That could be it,
well,
but
I think they want the Heather and Steve show. That's what they came here for.
Came for the Heather and Steve show? Okay, then I won't turn the camera for Ed, because you clearly don't want to watch him, but I'm just kidding.
Well, but I'm here every Friday.
I'm just kidding, they do.
I'm doing daily.
Heather says, bite me, Edward. Heather, the shy, retiring.
Yeah.
Shouldn't Heather be on vacation?
Passive.
Bite me, Edward.
A pacifist.
30 seconds. Shouldn't Heather be on vacation?
She's driving home from Colorado watching.
Heather, you should be on vacation.
That's right. No Heather, no viewers. That's it.
That's what it is. If the Heather and Steve show went international.
Heather, you see that? Without you, although we had some record-breaking numbers early in the week, so we won't look to those.
10 seconds.
We'll just say tonight without you, even with American Idol, we're tanking.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Our reality check includes the Cowboys' motives in the draft and if the Stars can capture the top seed in the Western Conference. But first, the Mavericks are just hoping to make the playoffs, and today they suffered another setback. Chandler Parsons will miss the rest of the season after having surgery on his right knee to repair a torn meniscus. Parsons was the Mavs' third-leading scorer, best three-point shooter, and had been playing some of the best basketball of his career the last couple of months. How much will this loss affect the Mavs' chances of making the playoffs? The Mavs are in big trouble. Dallas is currently in at the seventh spot, but 6 through 9 are separated by 1.5 games. But of those four, the Mavs have by far the toughest schedule. And in different computer simulations where the end of the season is simulated thousands of times, the Mavs have a much worse playoff probability than everybody else. No Parsons, no playoffs. Jason Garrett and company were at Ohio State today, likely looking at defensive lineman Joey Bosa and running back Ezekiel Elliott. Cowboys picked fourth in the draft, and while many say they need a quarterback both as a backup and as the future franchise player, the optics suggest they may be going in a different direction. Garrett is not even hinting at what the Cowboys will do with such a valuable pick.
The biggest thing with the draft right now is to evaluate players. And you don't want to get into draft strategy too early. You want to evaluate the players by really the feel for who they are at all positions. And then you stack them up and try to make the decisions and then do the best off the football. Every position can play for us is a fourth pick.
I will cheat and give you the strategy in advance. They're not going with a quarterback. Jerry Jones says Tony Romo will be the starter for the next few years, and there are many other reasons cited as to why they went 4-12 last season, like not having a fresh running game and needing more pass rushers. A quarterback may get chosen elsewhere, just not in the first round. Finally, the Dallas Stars have a 2-point lead in the Western Conference with 7 games left. Looks like a 2-team race for first between the Stars and Blues. They don't play each other the rest of the season. Can we expect Dallas to capture its first top seed in the West since 2003? I think they will. Let's go back to these computer simulations. While it's close, the Stars get a slight edge over the Blues by roughly a point. St. Louis does have one more game left to play than Dallas. Looks like the Blues will win and even the standings. Stars do have an easier schedule, though. The Blues still have 2 games left with the Capitals. Stars should win the West. Tonight at 10, are we on a collision course for Kansas and Oklahoma to tangle one more time, but this time in the Final Four? How the Sooners hope to do their part by making it happen by beating Oregon in the Elite Eight. Edward Egrott, Fox Sports Sports.
The Dallas Zoo's new monorail is up and running. One new feature that's sure to get you excited for those summer visits you will take coming up.
Song.
We'll sing it, Brandon. Monterey. It's American Idol night.
Monterey.
It's catchy.
All that in my head all week.
Rim came off my pudding can.
Oh, is it really?
That's
great. Oh, your can is...
Yeah, it's
spiraling cubes of Fox 4.
All right, Steven, put this over here. They don't have me running around for the 10 o'clock. Just
okay.
So you're aware.
Maybe I should look at the 10 o'clock scripts. Would that be a good idea?
Heather, Heather, stay awake.
She said hello to you.
Hey, Heather.
So, hello.
Drive safely.
Oh, you guys have big Easter weekend plans? Easter brunch somewhere? Going to a church service and then hitting brunch or something?
Wait a minute.
Don't quit my day job. What are you saying? Exactly. What, Diana, exactly are you saying?
I can sing? No, I can't. I can dance, though. No, I can't do that either. Heather, what are you doing? Offer us some entertainment on your drive. You're just like, hey, Lou, thanks, Lou. Hey, come on.
She didn't even say hi back to me.
Come on, Heather. Give us some. Give us a little something.
Just all VOs, Steve has one.
Just winging it for Easter. This was a fiasco 15. On Facebook, wasn't it? I don't know why.
Total how many people? It's not enough people. What's up with that, Steve? What are people
Facebook matter? Fiasco. It's a Lupe fiasco.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Thousands of Cubans are rocking out with the Rolling Stones right about now. The legendary rock band is performing a free concert right now in Havana. The concert in a country where rock and roll music was once silenced comes 3 days after President Obama wrapped up his visit to Cuba. The band's Cuba Stop follows concerts in Brazil, Uruguay, Chile, Argentina, and Mexico.
The Dallas Zoo's new monorail system is officially open to the public today. The zoo spent a year and a half and $3 million revamping the ride. The Wilds of Africa Safari Adventure lasts about 20 minutes. It gives you a look at some animals that you wouldn't see elsewhere in the zoo. And a new feature sure to come in handy this summer, air conditioning. Some Fox 4 viewers were there earlier today checking out the new ride.
Best shower voice. That's right. I'm deadly in a shower. Monorail.
Previous monorail broke down 3 times in recent years, stranding riders. The new system includes what's called a tug. It'll return the vehicle to the platform if it breaks down again. Well, the Fort Worth Zoo is extending its weekend hours now that spring temperatures are in full effect. Starting tomorrow, the zoo will be open from 10 to 6 every Saturday and Sunday. More Fox 4 News after the break.
Steve, make a boy band with Lou? Nah. I do want to tell you that I got an email today. Last night, if you guys were watching last night, Lou moved some of my stuff. When I was going to do a big golf thing, Lou got out of control. I had a box set over here and a putter that I was going to use against this 9-year-old number one in the world ranked golfer, and Lou moved the putter. I went to it's like it disappeared. My favorite all-time putter. Anyway, so I said, "Hey Lou, where'd you put that? Where is it?" I said over here, and Lou comes walking in with a putter, and I get an email today from a woman. It said, "Last night somebody handed you a putter during the thing. It was an African American man, very handsome, very good looking, wearing
man.
A red shirt. Mic check. It was all this like, what's his status? What's his story?" I'm like,
"He's mysterious."
That's Lou, man. And he's married.
We go to the 10 p.m. rundown, please.
Yeah.
Yeah,
it was really funny. A very handsome African American man with a red shirt and blue pants handed you. What's is he single? He's very handsome. I've never done something like this. I'm just curious. Okay. All right. Whatever. I know his wife frequently watches this little broadcast.
Coming out camera 2 and 2. 30 seconds. One light will come on.
Hey Lou, when this is all over, am I over there to start?
Yeah, you're going to start there. Anyway, you're bouncing around a big monitor.
Okay.
He's still here, did he leave?
They're gone. Yeah.
This thing will be ending a little early, right? We'll make it through the 10 o'clock news.
No,
anyway.
5, 4, 3, 2.
A robotics competition brought students from more than 40 of our area high schools to the Irving Convention Center.
It's called the First Robotics Competition. It feels more like a pep rally kind of atmosphere. Over a six-week time frame, teams of students worked with professional engineering mentors to design, build, and program their own robots. What's it like, Big Hero 6 movie, right? This weekend, they get judged on the effectiveness of each robot and awarded for sportsmanship and teamwork. Some will advance to the championship level. After it's all over, participating first students are eligible to apply for more than $25 million in scholarships.
Technology is a real, I like it, it's a teamwork.
Yeah.
I mean, they work teams and program and help each other write code. News is that way too.
Yes, it is.
I really think, but I think technology, that's where it happens more so than other places where it's all about. Get you out of the way so I can succeed.
Yeah, exactly.
All right, support continues to pour in for Fort Worth Officer Matt Pierce, shot in the line of duty.
Just ahead, how you can get involved in the newest effort to help. That story and more next on Fox 4 News at 10.
All right, Brandon, thank you. Thanks for being here.
Thoroughly enjoyed Steve's dust
that. You're going to be on Idol this week, too. Sweet.
Oh, yeah. Look at you.
You'll be the big man. Hi there again and good evening. I'm Steve Eager. We had a warm start to our holiday weekend, but there will be some isolated showers on Easter Sunday. Tonight, though, clear weather for an outdoor Good Friday service. Fellowship Church hosted the fourth annual Good Friday in the Park at downtown Dallas's Clyde Warren Park. Plenty of family-friendly entertainment, a hula hoop contest there for the kids, even an appearance by the Easter Bunny. Our chief meteorologist, Dan Henry, is in now. All right, nothing severe this weekend, but we might see some rain.
So, Steve, the next shot is a big monitor. Yeah, you just be standing here.
Where do I stand?
Right here.
Okay. Never done that before.
Yeah, we're kind of taking that shot.
A Denton College student has a stolen bike back, thanks to a Fox 4 News crew. There is clear surveillance video of the racing bike theft last night at the coffee shop where she works. And while covering the story this afternoon, our crew spotted and confronted a guy who looked a lot like the thief in the video. Zed Arm is in our Dallas newsroom with a story you'll see only on Fox 4. Zed. Everybody happy? Somebody says it's boring. Boring. So, when people say it's boring, I usually delete them. Dang it, I missed this one. Shoot. I here for a minute? No?
I will probably might have to put on this side.
I've been logged out again.
Oh, it ended?
No, knocked off the computer.
I'll move it over there.
Better? Can't connect. I got to restart the stupid computer. Dang it.
similar shoes.
Well, I'm glad she's still watching. I'm boring. Put myself to sleep.
Okay, thank you. For 140, correct?
Yes, sir.
1 to 2. Thank you. I restarted it. I'll get there.
Why, thank you, random man on the street. Did you want to? Where to put it? He agrees to walk us to his apartment.
30 seconds.
The guy who would not give us his name hands over the bike and splits. Rector reported the theft to Denton police and plans to press charges. The race is back.
I thought we said she was didn't plan to press charges.
Numbers, private eye.
But oh my gosh.
Didn't she say she wasn't going to press charges? At 9?
Thank you.
Maybe she changed. All right, especially if Raul Cantu and you are on the story. That worked out fantastic. All right, Zahid, nice job tonight. Thanks. The political back and forth between Ted Cruz and Donald Trump took another really nasty, dirty turn today. The National Enquirer is set to publish an article claiming Cruz is a cheater, as in married cheater. And Cruz says it's Trump who planted that story. Fox 4's Alex Boyer has details tonight. He's live in downtown Dallas. Alex.
He's attacking my family. Republican presidential contender Ted Cruz is playing defense. And this garbage does not belong.
Okay, let's go forward.
The Texan forced to go off message in order to tackle a tabloid article and a political opponent he believes kind of defeat Donald Trump.
That is his first and last resort. 2 minutes.
That was a pretty good story, right, friend of that bike. That photographer, Raul Cantu, is awesome. I love the way he went up to him and kind of... Do I still do the mean viewer's voice emails? Diana, are you watching us enough? I don't think you are. You're welcome. I know sometimes it gets slow, but... I got it back. I mean, I had to log off.
Okay.
I'm going to try to not have... I seem to end up with laptop 3 a lot. How about... Is there... What are the other... What's not 2 or 3? Can next time, let's work... Will you be here Monday? No. You're off. I'm going to look for... I'm going to try... I'm just going to try laptop 4 just to do something different, you know? So... I wonder if it's something having to do with my login. It's happened on 2 different ones. You know, because, I mean, this knows when I log in, it has a few saved things, and maybe there's some bad code or something. I don't know. Yes, laptop 3 is so bad luck. The worst luck. Upside down, but they've made them. They're not really upside down. They're upside down if you look at it this way. But they didn't. You know how cufflinks are bent. It's got to be this way. Okay, Alex Boyer. Thank you. As a Fort Worth police officer is critically wounded in a shootout, fights to recover, his brothers in blue are coordinating an effort to raise funds for him. Fox Sports Phil Alvarado, John Peter Smith Hospital, where Officer Matt Pierce is being treated. Okay, a lot of support. Who else is involved besides fellow officers tonight, Phil? Try to get it back, but that's what happens. You always overshoot it because there's a little stress involved. It's like boom, boom. You know, I had the script, guys. Teleprompter. What a night. I'd like to claim the seed. Now you know I just don't read the teleprompter. I can function without it. This night.
It's been a busy night, man.
This night is crazy.
It's been busy on that kind of ground.
I wasn't that busy, though. I didn't do much.
Crew the same way. Just a problem. Two of everything.
Oh, I wonder if Heather's still on. Heather, you still on? Heather's going to be mad she was off tonight. She could be on American Idol next week.
Mm-hmm. That was her interview.
That was her interview, man.
Her girls could have came and seen Dalton.
That's right. That would have been her interview.
Send up the Phil's Packers.
Okay, Phil Alvarado, thank you very much. Police hope someone will recognize the composite sketch we're about to show you and lead them to a man who may have attempted to abduct a 10-year-old child in the Collin County town of Anna. The Texas Rangers worked with the child to produce this detailed sketch from the January 28th incident. Since then, parents in four other Collin and Grayson County communities reported other suspicious behavior by a man who looked a lot like the man in this sketch. So this one incident we're talking about happened January 28th. Police say it took this long to produce the sketch because of difficulty scheduling a meeting between the girl's family and the Texas Rangers sketch artist. Former teacher's aide from Allen High School will serve 4 years probation for having an improper relationship with a 16-year-old student. 22-year-old Kearney Day pleaded guilty to the charge. Prosecutors dropped 8 other charges in exchange for that guilty plea. In addition to probation, Day must perform 120 hours of community service and pay a $500 fine. She is no longer allowed to have unsupervised contact with children. The collapse of this Dallas parking garage in October left some dealing with a parking hassle coming up. How soon this headache will be over for nearly 1,000 people who live in that area. And it's a big weekend for American Idol's top 4 finalist, Dalton Repitone. He visited our studios tonight for the news at 9. More on his hometown tour in DFW coming up.
An update on an incomplete Mavericks roster facing the Warriors. And what's Oklahoma's mindset as they try to make its first Final Four since 2002? That's later in sports.
Okay, so you want... I don't mean to be nitpicky. I want to know if you feel the same way. So the person trying to lure the child, get a rope, get a gun, castrated. I assume that's that guy in the
in the sketch. How about the teacher at Allen High School? How do you feel about that? Hey, Darlene, thanks for being here. Hey, hey. Yes, with this thing, I'm controlling it. What do you think? A lot of people are wanting to string up the dude. How about the female who had a relationship with a 16-year-old, the teacher? I don't know. I'm not sure either. I don't like it if it were my son. But they're both sort of, they would both be considered child predators, right?
What?
Same. Okay, Catherine. All right. Consistent. I like that you're consistent. I like that. A lot of men aren't consistent. That's what I should say.
Ed's going to come and sit down with you on a two-shot. But he's done.
I know a lot of men who say, like,
no, I'm saying Ed.
A man who prays like little girls should be a bullet to the head, and then women and young men, it's like, well, you know, I don't know. It doesn't seem right to me, but I don't know. No double standards. I like it.
You could have. He wanted to meet you. 15, Steve. Coming up on one.
Okay. All right. Here we go.
Dan, you want to walk.
I'll miss you over here, Dan.
4, 3, 2.
American Idol finalist Dalton Rapitone from Sunnyvale is back in North Texas for his Idol hometown visit. You watched him perform on the show last night. That's just after he found out he made it into the Final Four. Today, he did a radio interview over at the Wolf 99.5 and met with some of his fans. Then he came here to the Fox 4 News studios at 9 o'clock. Talked with our Brandon Todd about his rise in fame.
For me, like, I'm a very kind of self-deprecating person, so every time that happens, I'm like, why are these people taking the time out? Don't they have things to do, like important things? And don't involve, like, wasting their time with little salty. But no, it's amazing, and I appreciate it. It's so crazy that people are listening.
It's going to be several busy days in a row. I heard him say, I think he said he hadn't slept yet. He had to fly out here, do all the busy day tomorrow too. 8:30 in the morning, he'll be at his grandmother's salon, the Villagers Beauty Salon. That's hometown visit right there. I love that. That's followed by a visit to the School of Rock in Rockwall, 10 a.m. That's where he teaches. And starting at 4 tomorrow afternoon, his parade in Sunnyvale. And it all wraps up at 5 o'clock with a concert at Town Center Park in Sunnyvale. We will also have all of tomorrow's events listed online on our website, fox4news.com.
Overall, Easter weekend not looking too bad. Tomorrow, partly sunny day, breezy, very mild, up to 77 degrees. Very late
Saturday night.
I think it's going to be really after midnight.
Turn this around.
Morning on Sunday, we'll see about a 30% chance of a passing shower or thunderstorm. Turning much cooler on Sunday behind the front as well, 64 the high, and those winds will kick up at the north-northwest. There is a marginal risk of severe weather late Saturday night during the wee morning hours of Sunday, primarily though up here in southwestern Oklahoma from roughly Lawton down through the Wichita Falls area back towards Childress. But this does kind of nose into northern and northwestern sections of North Texas around Gainesville, back through Montague County. We could see a few storms have some marginally severe hail in them up to the size of quarters. I think that's going to stay well to the north and northwest, though, of the Dallas-Fort Worth area. Jerry Madonna today, 75 the afternoon high after a morning low of 29. And we did see some patchy frost outside of the Dallas-Fort Worth area early this morning. 69 officially at DFW. 41 the morning low, 71 and 49 the averages. Pollen count today way up there, over 1,000. Ash, grass, maple, and oak. Air quality good, and the UV index was high at 7. Already down to 55 in Fort Worth. Meantime, it's still 64 in Dallas, 59 in Allen. Winds are currently blowing lightly. Southeast at 9, the humidity at 49%. Our next weather maker moving quickly near Salt Lake City right now. That's going to track to our north through northern Oklahoma tomorrow, and that'll keep the better rain chances off to our north as well. Saturday looks great, starting out at 52. 71 at noontime will top out tomorrow afternoon in the mid to upper 70s. 36 in Denver, it's 51 in Memphis, and 56 out west in San Francisco. So we play out future cast. Tomorrow's a good-looking day. Mix of sunny clouds, breezy and mild, well into the 70s. And then here comes Sunday morning. We're talking about 3 o'clock in the morning. There could be a cluster of some isolated thunderstorms on the Red River. A few of those could have some hail in them, and then they will continue to move east with a few showers, maybe a rumble of thunder or two in the Dallas-Fort Worth area early to mid-morning on Sunday. But Easter Sunday afternoon, we bring back the sunshine with cooler temperatures, 64. 70s return next week, and by the middle of the week, there could be the chance of some more scattered, strong to severe thunderstorms.
A repaired Oaklawn Dallas parking garage is expected to reopen next week, and people who live in the area say it's about time. Still unclear what caused floors to pancake on top of each other 5 months ago at the Renaissance on Turtle Creek. Remember, they were working on a pool and had piled up a lot of dirt on the roof there. The accident reduced the number of available parking spaces by more than 900. Meanwhile, many Turtle Creek residents have been using street parking over the last 5 months, making it harder for people in all the surrounding areas to find spots.
There's cars overnight here and parked everywhere and all up and down the Turtle Creek on the street, so this has been a thing.
You know, you can't have people visit because there's no place for them to park, and the traffic, the size of the parking, it's just the traffic of everybody trying to find a place to park has been a mess.
Okay, so the only thing between opening and getting people in there, city inspection of the parking structure and parking spot paint striping, that's it.
Chandler Parsons is out for the season after having surgery on his right knee. And with more critical games for playoff positioning ahead, Rick Carlisle sitting out Dirk Nowitzki, Darren Williams, and Devin Harris for tonight's game with the Warriors. Good loss. Before the game, former Warrior David Lee finally received his championship ring he won last season. He's getting his first start for the Mavs tonight. Wes Matthews also starting, also tripling. So do the Warriors. Steph Curry, Klay Thompson, even Draymond Green going long range. Right now, Golden State up 45-40 in the second. Buddy Hield, the Sooners are in the Elite Eight for the first time in 7 years. Tomorrow, they get Oregon. It will be the first time these two schools have met in 75 years. They can meet up with Kansas in the Final Four if the Jayhawks win their Elite Eight game tomorrow night. Of course, Oklahoma wins as well. But for now, it's about putting the Aggie win behind them and looking ahead.
To be one of only eight who will play again is very special. So appreciate again what you did. You understand that you got to do it again. You have to.
Are you here?
Other Sweet 16 scores from tonight. Notre Dame knocks off Wisconsin 61-56. Virginia beats Iowa State by 13. Gonzaga and Syracuse, they are in a tight one. Right now the Zags up by 1. And North Carolina leading Indiana by 11. Baylor women's coach Kim Mulkey has partially built her program around recruiting DFW. Alexis Jones is one of her more successful players. The junior out of Irving MacArthur should have a lot of family and friends watching her tomorrow in the Dallas Regional.
They took this long journey with me. Ever since I was a little bad, I've always been at every single last one of my games. So I know that it hurt them a lot to not be at the games that they had been and not to be able to make the special games like they wanted to.
WGC Match Play Championship in the state capital. Former Longhorn Jordan Spieth, the Jordan River. See what they did there. He's playing Justin Thomas, par 4, first, sinks the birdie. Then on 5, another birdie putt. He wins the match 3-2 and advances to pool play. Spieth will likely play Louis Oosthuizen, another major champion in the round of 16.
I love how he refers to he and his caddy. We, it's always we.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
And when a shot goes up, oh, Mike.
Right, exactly. Oh, then it's you. Exactly.
It's a shared responsibility. All right. Edward, nice
He job. Knows how to do it. He's, well, wise beyond his years.
Thanks a lot.